Hi friends, welcome to my super learning channel. Today we are going to discuss about spreadsheet, how to use the available template. So there are a lot of templates available inbuilt within, either if you use Microsoft Excel or WPS spreadsheet. So this will be the first tab, my WPS. And if you look at the templates tab, you will have a set of templates available under different category, like productivity. If you want to have some productivity related templates, then you can go and pick from this category. And calendar, there are lots of calendar formats are available, which you can use it to build a simple calendar for tracking your daily events. And similarly business and finance. So I'm going to talk about a finance one, and you can also see at the bottom there are pages to navigate. Okay, so let me pick a random one which is having lots of graphs. As soon as you click this, you will see a preview window, like how this template will appear, and there will be a download option. As you click the download option, you could see it gets added as a fresh new tab, and you can go and change the values and the product. So this is a typical sales related spreadsheet template. So I'm just going to leave the products as it is. So looking at this, it looks like cosmetics and beauty products. And if you see the clients who have used mobile to purchase them are categorized by quantity and the sales volume, and people who have used computers for the purchase, the trend is given by product, and the total quantity and total sales volume is given here as a formula. They have summed up the quantities separately and then sales volume separately. So this is a simple trending one. Probably I can go and change one or two items so that you can see the difference. Instead of 68, I would say 50. As soon as I tab out, you can see the graphs getting changed, right? I'm just undoing that. Please see if you have missed to notice. See, all three graphs are getting changed at the same time. That's the beauty of this template. And as you all know, this comes with the same type chart type, so which gets filled with the selected data. So that's how the graphs are linked. So we normally call this as dashboard. If you want to go and select different charts, you can go and pick the one you prefer, and then make the, if you click on OK, then it gets applied. The bottom line is you can give different perspectives of the data in graphical representation, which the senior management would be more interested to know just by looking at the graphs. So I would suggest you to explore more and try different charts and different types of perspectives that you can bring into the data. So data analytics is one of the key area that is growing, and it is more important for us to learn and understand the importance, how we can make use of data and produce different perspectives which will help the organization to look forward and take it forward based on the data driven analytics, right? So that's the key. Just to give another view on this, so you could see by product, this has been classified by quantity, and then so different clients, which means the mobile client and computer client. So it is shaded with dark and light blue. The similar color coding is used for the donut chart as well, and there is a line graph. So this is very useful one when you look at based on the trend, so how the volume, sales volume goes against the quantities. And all these legends are very important when you plot any graph, because the mere numbers or mere graph doesn't give you much information when it is taken as a printout or a hard copy, right? Unless you have these legends, it is difficult to read. So that's why it's highly recommended that you always have the required legends, but do not clutter the graphs. Many a times people used to do this by adding all those legends, all those fields, all those tables underneath the charts. That will not look nice because it will occupy most of the real estate space here, and it will not be appealing to the viewer. We should keep the minimal information, but at the same time the required information should also be present in that chart. Try out different things. And one more thing I want to show is, this also shows the sales volume comparison. So the first one we have seen by quantity, now the second one is volume comparison. They have used different shades, you could see, just to make a variation. The previous one was by the depth of the color or intensity. Now it has been differentiated in the sales volume by filling it with the gradient lines. That's another perspective, right? So you can give a different variation, and this will give a nice perspective to the user. And always remember that we may be sharing this data to the management or whoever. So remember, the target audience who will be seeing this data has the sufficient information, and we are not cluttering the information too much. And one another thing is, if you want to take this chart to a presentation or a PPT, then you can easily port it between the presentation application, because these are all integrated applications. So that is more useful. You can copy the entire chart and then paste it in a PowerPoint presentation. Always make sure you link that, so that whenever the data gets changed, it gets refreshed in the chart or in the presentation. Otherwise, if you don't want to integrate both, then you can just paste the content as a picture within the PowerPoint slide. And one more thing, when you prepare the dashboards, always make sure you go and check the view tab, where you will have view grid lines, right? If I give that, automatically the grid lines are viewed, right? You can see the grid lines. Because of the color, it's not very clear. Yeah, I have removed the eye protection mode. Now you can see the lines are there, which is not appealing. So you need to uncheck the view grid lines so that it gives a precisely the dashboard look. And it's also good to have this eye protection mode so that when you work with minute details, you don't strain yourself much. I hope you have enjoyed this session. Please share your feedback in the comment section. And if you want to learn anything else, please feel free to ask me. If I know, I can share it with you. And thanks for watching the video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. It's your super learning channel. Thanks guys. See you next time. Bye.